Hair, Love, Radio.
You're listening to Hair Love Radio, where we get into the nitty-gritty of what it takes to make your dreams a reality, start unlocking your potential, and live your best life, helping hairstylists, creatives, and girl bosses spread their awesome and light like confetti. You were made for awesome. Hi, welcome back to Hair Love Radio. I am your host, Elizabeth Faye. I am here with Lo Wheeler, our hair love artist and friend. And today we are going to talk a little bit about how you are what you eat. As hairstylists, we have a tendency to not take care of our bodies behind the chair as far as food goes. I would say across the board, it's pretty common that we drink a lot of coffee, we eat things pretty quickly, or like you see all those funny memes about inhaling whatever food is around and going back to our guests, we're double, triple booked, and that really does take a toll on your body. It doesn't make you feel good. It does not give you the fuel you need. And it is a lot of work to change something like that in our work environment because we don't necessarily have a lunch break. And so I want to ask Lo some questions that I think is really interesting. As someone who's been her friend, we met in 2015. We've been friends for quite some time now. I have seen a big transformation, not only in your appearance, but in the way you eat. And I've noticed through what you're posting and just like hanging around you, I've noticed throughout the years that your food has changed. And I want to ask you, I have questions. So what started your change in your food lifestyle and with your diet and the way you approach food and your relationship with that in general?
Hi. Well, wow. I just feel like, you know, over the past year to 3 years, it's just been a little bit of everything. For one, I just have to say that there's been so much confusion and information in various, you know, Netflix documentaries that are telling you what to do with your wellness, life, and food habits. And I've just been taking all of that in, and some of my really, really close friends are on totally different sides of the food spectrum. You know, I have some friends that are like hardcore paleo, CrossFit people, and other close friends in my arena that are completely strict plant-based raw vegans. And I've had, you know, a lot of their influence over the years, you know, guiding my own personal decision making. But taking it back to why is, I've been in the industry for 15, 16 years eating just like, you know, nothing but coffee, and then come 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon, totally all the adrenaline runs out of the, my blood sugar's dropped and I'm starving, and I've wolfed down like a, you know, 1 pound hamburger and just, you know, seen that like normal behavior of like 10 years of my career, I would do that.
And yeah, just, and I feel like that's super common.
It's so normal. It's just like the normal behavior. And, you know, only when I got injured did I start thinking about my diet and how it related back to my work. And
so let's talk about that. You got injured. Where, what, how, explain.
So 4 years ago, I got into a car accident where I got rear-ended on the freeway. It totally spun out my vehicle. And after that, I could not get my back right.
Really?
I totally had some kind of like pinched sciatica, and it was, you know, it wasn't like a devastating thing. I definitely could work, and I, you know, things could have been much worse. So I'm grateful that it wasn't. But I started really noticing, you know, my body was not recovering, and I've always had issues with my autoimmune like health forever. And until I hurt my back, did I start putting two and two together that what I'm putting into my body and is affecting not only my inflammation and my back problems, but it was also flaring up my autoimmune, which I had lived with forever. And so I I got to a point where I couldn't even get out of bed certain days because I would be working, you know, 8-hour salon days, and then the next day I couldn't get out of bed because my back hurts so bad.
And you're so young.
So I started to like really take a look at that and get as much information as possible. And my good friends were telling me, do this. You need to like do yoga and eat only, you know, lean proteins. And then I had my other friends saying like, you need to juice ginger and just cut out all sources of animal proteins. And so I just took all of that and became really overwhelmed. And I just started looking into it and making small changes for myself and measuring how my body was feeling.
So what did that look like? Like, what was a small change going from before? Were you just kind of eating like the regular American diet? Yes.
Yes. Okay. Absolutely.
So then regular American diet, regular hairstylist, like eating times of the day. And what did a small change look like in the beginning for you?
So you guys have to remember this is all over a course of like the last 4 years. I think change is really hard to do when you try to go cold turkey in any direction. So a small change for me at that point was just trying to drink more water.
Yeah, no, totally. And, well, and as hairstylists, we don't drink anything, or maybe an energy drink, because we have two hands with foil and hair. And so like all of us are dehydrated and probably anemic.
Yeah, it's like something I still struggle with is drinking enough water. But back at that time, I just making the decision to start with sugar and eliminate unnecessary sugar. So at that point in time, I cut a lot of creamer and sweetener out of my coffee. And then that led me to, you know, really trying to clean up saturated fats, like less fried. And that kind of led me down a journey to where a whole year went by where I went super strictly vegan. And with that experience, I felt like my inflammation came down and I was able to function a little bit better. But as far as like my, you know, emotional relationship with food, I felt like, you know, I didn't know that being 100% vegan was sustainable for me because of my relationship with like what I actually enjoy eating.
Right.
And so I've kind of come full circle. Like I like to eat as much plant-based foods as possible, like as much fruit, vegetables, seeds, nuts, beans, greens, as much as I can. And then I will sprinkle in like some pescatarian dishes where there's like shrimp protein, fish, pokey, sushi proteins in there time to time. I definitely sprinkle in a little bit of cheeses. It's like my guilty pleasure, but I notice my own personal health when I do dairy, it inflames me. So I really have to pick and choose. It's more of like,
and did you figure this out just by solely trying different things?
Honestly, it took me just research because there's certain categories of food that are inflammatory foods. So if you're a stylist like me that you suffer from chronic back problems, which a lot of hairstylists do, or you suffer from acne or psoriasis or any like skin issues.
Well, and I remember when I met you, I had really bad acne too. But I know we were talking about adult acne and your face is clear now. And would you attest that a lot of to what you're putting in your body?
Absolutely. Because the body does, and like I'm definitely not an authority in this, but I can tell you what has worked for me and what I've researched. It's the body can either be in a state of inflammation or not. And when your body is inflamed, it produces mucus, and mucus equals sickness and disease. And inflammation causes like joint pain and skin issues. So over the process of me really narrowing down what my body didn't like, it all led back to inflammatory foods. So although, you know, like I genuinely love cheese, I know that that's a conscious decision that I'm going to be making, like, I'll say like, okay, like I can have this cheese pizza, but I know how my body's going to react to it. I know I might get like some acne, residual acne, or I'll wake up achy. So that's a decision I make before I eat a piece of pizza. But I think that it's important to just do what you can sustain, because going on the whole other, you know, radical, like I was strict vegan for a year. I felt really good with that. But I also felt with my travel schedule, like I couldn't really sustain that. I felt that something was like maybe, you know, like, really not, it wasn't an easy thing to do.
No, going to restaurants, events, show schedules.
Airports, like.
Yeah.
Just like 6 months ago, I saw the first vegan restaurant in an airport I've ever seen. And I was like, wow, this is like really awesome. So I don't know. I just like figure like if there's a plant-based option, I'll take that first. And then if I have to do something else, I'll like figure it out. But I always weigh the result it's going to have on my body. But if I can encourage hairstylists to do anything, it's try drinking more water.
Yeah.
And research inflammation, because inflammation is a hairstylist's worst enemy.
For
because
sure.
We can't afford to be sick. We can't afford to
no.
be achy.
Well, and to have a 20, 30-year career, I mean, the truth is if we don't take care of ourselves, we're screwed, right? We need our bodies to be able to do this career. And I think all of us can attest that I think all of us experience pain at young ages from our job, whether it's in our wrist or our back or our shoulders. I mean, even doing this podcast, I keep adjusting my shoulders, and it's something I have to work on my posture a lot, or I feel like I'm in pain and the way I hold things is important. And I even get pain from being on Instagram now from my wrist. And so I have to be conscious of the way I hold my wrist and when I'm typing and different things like that. So that's why I wanted to dive into this with you, is because in order to have a long career doing what we love, if we don't take care of ourselves, we get that option taken away from us. And that is so, that's sad. That's really sad. That'd be so heartbreaking. And it happens all the time. And both of us are really young, and I have noticed a huge change in the way you've eaten just throughout the years, and what you've said, what you look like, what you talk about. So I think that's interesting. And maybe if you guys email in enough, we can convince Lo to share some of her hairdresser-friendly recipes on our blog.
Oh.
That might be a fun lowdown on the blog. So
I would definitely be open to that. It's like kind of another little tidbit I have is it's, you know, you tend to eat what's socially normal in your environment too. So it's like I have gone from like salon environments where everybody's like, we're ordering cheeseburgers. Do you want one? And like the path of least resistance is yes.
Yeah.
You know, and like you're like, okay, shoot, I haven't eaten in like 8 hours. I should eat something. And like this is accessible and easy. Going from that environment, I follow the cultural norms. In my new environment with my salon, I think it's like almost like literally a unsaid thing where everybody is so nutritional at my salon. And it's like I could be the one that brings in like fried donuts and no one's touching them. Awesome. You know? And so like maybe if you guys like we can just kind of do like a bird's eye view of like what my salon does like habitually for like nutrition and snacks. And I'm just like, they keep me on.
No, and I think that's awesome. We actually have a nutritionist who is making some recipes, but I think it would be great to have a hairstylist making some recipes of just maybe like, what do you pack? What are you grabbing in the back room? Just because you're coming from an actual hairstylist point of view versus a nutritionalist, you know what I mean? Who's a professional, but not necessarily someone who's doing the day-to-day salon owner, hairdresser grind. So I'm going to talk you into that.
Absolutely. I'm 100% down. Yeah. I will say like one last thing in regards to like, you know, doing what's right for yourself on a food and nutrition basis. Don't label yourself. Like, I feel like labels are so played out, and you don't owe your friend an explanation why you're going to eat a donut versus a green juice. Just be accountable to yourself and try to make good decisions in that week and that day, because I feel like the second I claimed, oh, I eat a, you know, vegan diet or plant-based or pescatarian or whatever it is, a paleo or keto, then other people hold you to your actions and it's so unnecessary. And it's very sabotaging. So
yeah, I love that.
I just like try to, like I've mentioned in my platform before, I'm freegan because I do whatever I freegan want in that moment.
Oh my God, I love that.
And it's just like whatever makes me feel happy and good and, you know, right with myself that day, I do that. But I also take the initiative to research what's good and healthy and balanced.
Yeah, but you're the only one who knows what certain foods feel like in your body. A cheese may make you feel terrible, and a cheese may not for someone else, right? So at the end of the day, it's what your body needs as fuel. And obviously, there's like nutritional facts, but at the end of the day, I love that. I love the freegan concept. Like, find out what works for you. Like, be healthy, fuel yourself, have a long career, but let's be freegan. I love that.
Freegan. Freegan and mindful.
Yeah, love that. That's beautiful.
And just create your own normal, because if you just follow what your salon does, it's not always in your best interest. And then you might change the cultural norm in your environment.
Totally.
By packing sensible things that make you have more energy throughout the day.
Totally. Well, it's like if you see someone trying a new lightener that's working well, you're going to try it. So totally be the change you want to see. Love it. Well, thank you so much for being here today on Hair Love Radio. We love having you always.
Love you.
And we will put some fun stuff in the show notes for you guys about Low and her freaganness. So thank you for being here. And as always,
we hair love you.
Hair Love Radio.